Have you got a horse? Those who have horse, please raise your hand.
What is that horse?
Your mind. So, your mind is the horse. Right? But is your mind trained? Or it goes wherever you want?
Wherever.
The horse has to go where you say. But does it go where you say or you go where it says? You have a well-trained horse?
Sometimes.
So you need a well-trained horse. Understand? That well-trained horse is called mind. Without mind, you cannot do the journey. But with mind, you cannot journey because whatever the horse takes, you go. Are you able to understand? So some amount of training of the mind is required. Okay? So how do you train the mind? Horse has a rein. You know what is rein? That horse will have the control that a rope will be there, no? Correct? So that's called rein of the horse. So where is the rein of your horse? Please show me, tell me. Don't tell me my husband and my wife, okay? So where is the rein of your horse? Anybody who knows the answer, can you please raise your hand? Swapna? So where is the rein of your hand? Horse? Where is the horse? How do you hold the horse?
Our desires.
The desires will take you anywhere you want. That's not the rein, that's not a controlling. That will just go anywhere you want. The horse will go wherever it finds grass. Does it go where you want? You want to go to Atma, no?
Yes.
And what is the control?
Breath.
Huh?
Breath. Sense organs.
Sense organs will take you wherever you want. Outside. The horse will go outside. The horse has to go inside, no? Yes, Vinay?
Vinit?
Breath.
Okay, the breath.
I think if you have the goal, then that will just direct you to that.
The goal is you should need a master. Okay, master is the buddhi, intellect. The rein is the mind, breath. The breath is the rein. Okay, you understand? The goal is given by the master, who is the buddhi. But if mind doesn't behave, you have to use the rein. Are you clear? So first let's learn to slow down the mind, slow down the horse. Let us slow down the horse, okay? How do you slow down the horse?
I think by observing the breath.
Yes. Shailaja, can you hear me?
Meditation
is finally where you go. Okay, so first mute your audios.
But Hari Om, Prabhuji.
Hari Om, mute and keep your video on, but audio mute. Okay, Satyalata, your video is off. Satyalata, you can keep your video on. Geeta also, Katyani also, Surya also. I want to see your nice faces. Don't hide, no. Okay, why Satyalata you are hiding? Okay. So, the breath is the rein, okay? Now let us know how to slow down the horse. The horse can be slowed down by reducing the speed of breath. When you reduce the speed of the breath, the mind also slow down. Right? So are you able to hear, Satyalata? Your audio is off.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay. So don't hide, huh? I want to see your faces, at least today.
You will not let us hide.
Okay.
You already found us out.
Okay. Okay. So, the horse has to be slowed down. How? By reducing the speed of breath. What is your normal speed of breath per minute? How much you breathe per minute?
10.
We can't count that, so I don't know the count.
Okay. Anybody knows when you're normal breathing?
10 to 12.
10 to 12. When you're excited?
Maybe it is more. 15.
When you're angry, 15.
More than 20.
Correct. Okay, so if horse has to go fast, you have to breathe faster.
Yes.
If you want to be angry with somebody, breathe faster. Are you clear? If you want to be peaceful with somebody, you have to breathe slow. Is this clear? The horse has to be, speed has to be reduced. So if you reduce the speed of the horse, the mind becomes slow. So from 10 to 12 you reduce it to 3-4, but don't force it. Slowly bring it down. Slowly, no forcing. The horse will not listen. If you bring it fast, so the horse will refuse to come. So you have to bring it slowly. Okay. Then have you seen how the child breathes? Breathing of the child, you have seen? How? What is special about breathing of the child?
It
breathes fast, but it breathes deep. The stomach will go up. Right? So child breathes into
the belly movement.
Belly movement into the abdomen. Okay? So two things you have to learn. You have to breathe like a child. Slowly. And you have to breathe slow. Slowly you have to come down your breathing speed. Is it clear? Breathe like a child and breathe slowly. So as you do that, there's a lot of cooling happens. The mind cools, the brain cools, the body starts feeling cooling. This is the step number one. All are clear? So next 10 minutes, we'll breathe like a child, okay? But breathe slow so that your horse has to come down, horse has to slow down. Are we clear? So let us practice this next 10 minutes, slow breathing, right? Slow and deep breathing. Let us start. Yellaru, all of you, start slow and deep breathing. Close your eyes. Slow, deep breathing so that your brain, mind starts cooling down. slow as possible, as gently as possible, as deep as possible. Pratibha starts breathing deep and slow. Breathe in deep and slow, like a child. Deep breathing, slow and deep breathing. Slowly open your eyes. So everybody's horse is under control. Anybody's horse is not under control, can you please raise your hand? Somebody's horse is running fast. What, Vineet? Your horse is running fast or what? So everybody understood this first step? It is very simple. Anybody has a difficulty? Mind, can you see the mind becoming, mind's calming down, mind becoming slow? First 2-3 minutes what?
I didn't recognize my breathing.
Oh, okay.
So then I came to my slowly, you said, no? So I
could not
okay.
Okay.
Okay, but mind comes down, mind becomes slow, mind becomes peaceful?
Yeah.
Okay, somebody is asking a question, who is that?
Guruji, in between, mind was peaceful.
Huh.
But in between, the time taken to breathe in was more. But still, after the breathe out and again to take the breathe in, it was taking, there was a little more gap between
that. That's perfectly alright. All those gaps I will explain in the next classes.
Okay.
So this is perfectly alright. First is to calm down your mind, make the mind slow. Are you clear?
Yeah, that happened.
So, congratulations. You have run the first step. The first step is called the 3-step meditation process. The first step is called Dharana. Okay, what is that? Can you repeat?
Dharana.
Dharana means what? Can anybody tell
dharana.
Me? What is the dharana, meaning of dharana? Anybody can understand? What is dharana? Dharana means what do you understand by the word dharana? Rajini?
To keep hold something on mind.
Dharana means to hold. Right? Dharana means to hold. Are we clear? First step is called dharana. There are 3 steps. Dharana, dhyana, samadhi. Okay? So first step is called dharana, means hold. Why do you hold somebody, something? To get a support. Right? When the mother and child are going, mother child holds the hand of the mother. Others will fall. Correct? That's called dharana. When somebody learns swimming, they will put a tire. Okay? And that's called dharana. When you sit for meditation, you need a dharana. Dharana is the breath. Are you clear? Dharana can be a mantra also, but I will teach only breath here. Breath based dharana. It can be mantra also, mantra japa also, but we will use only breath as dharana. Are you clear? What is the purpose of dharana? To hold you, to get a support. So everybody understood dharana, what dharana is?
Guruji, support of what, Guruji?
Breath, no. To make the mind silent, you need a support of breath, no. Right? Otherwise mind is running, no.
Yeah.
Where all it runs?
Yeah.
Hmm? Correct?
Yeah.
So whenever mind is running fast, you hold the breath and bring it down the slow, down the speed. That's called dharana. That can you do anytime. When you get angry with somebody, before you hit somebody, bring the horse to slow down. Before you hitting. After hitting, nothing will happen. You cannot do. After hitting, you will also get hit. Right? When you are angry with somebody, before throwing your phone and destroying the phone, breathe. Slow down. Is dharana clear to all? Let us go to next step. Okay?
I have a question.
Ah, you have a question. Ask.
Why do we do dharana?
You tell me what you understand.
You had told like to work or something.
See, dharana, whenever you do, dharana means support, right?
Yeah.
So you need a support for anything. For example, study, you need a support of books.
Yeah.
Okay. And if you are going with your mother, you need a support of your mother. You hold the hand of the mother.
Yeah.
Right? So we need support initially. Like that, for meditation also we need initial support.
Okay.
The initial support to make the mind slow. So that is the breath.
Okay, got it.
Got it?
Yeah.
So let us go to next step, dhyana. Okay? Dhyana means what? Third step is samadhi. Dharana, dhyana, samadhi. Are you clear? So what do you understand by dhyana? Can you tell me, anybody tell me? Can anybody tell me what is dhyana? Lata? What is dhyana, meditation?
Dhyana, I think it's tapasya maybe.
Dhyana is concentration, focus. Okay? You imagine, no? You just sit, somebody is sitting in a horse. He's riding a horse. Okay? So he has slowed down the horse. Now what is doing slow down? After that slow down, he slowly sees something. Now he is not looking around, he is just seeing. Right? So you have to see now. Next step is seeing. Okay? Are we clear? So what do you see? What do you see? Shruti? What do you see?
Movement of breath.
Movement of breath is over. That's to bring the horse. Slow down the horse. After that, what do you see? So a horse is, you are riding a horse, imagine. So you're like a king or queen. You're riding a horse. You're going. And you slow down the horse. Then you look around. Slow. See. What do you look around?
Thoughts. The aim is to see.
Aim is to see?
Myself.
Before you see, you cannot see yourself. That's the whole problem. You cannot see yourself. You are B. So,
aim is to see myself.
So, what you have to do, you cannot see yourself. Okay? What you see is not you.
Yes.
Alright? For example, I can see this glass. So, I am not the glass. I am the seer. Correct? Are you clear? So what I see, I am not. Right? Are you clear, Shruti? So you can see your glasses, you are not glasses. So you have to see one by one. Annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vidnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha to see. That's not you. Right? You have to see what you are not. Then can you see yourself? You can just be. You cannot see yourself. You can see this is not me, this is not, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am not Annamaya Kosha, I am not Pranamaya Kosha, I am not Manomaya Kosha, I am not Vidnanamaya Kosha, I am not Anandamaya Kosha, I am. Like that, you have to cross the different gates. Are we clear? Is everybody clear? So, I see my hand, I am not my hand. Correct? I see Annamaya Kosha, I am not Annamaya Kosha. I see Pranamaya Kosha, then I am not Pranamaya Kosha. I see Manomaya Kosha, I am not Manomaya Kosha. I see Vidnanamaya Kosha, I am not Vidnanamaya Kosha. I am the seer. Is this clear?
The sensations also come in Annamaya Kosha.
Yes.
But who is that? I am the seer who is telling.
Telling is the seer. But who says?
Seeing.
Can you ask the question?
I am there.
No, who is seer? I am the seer. Is the body seer?
Yeah.
No, the one who sees through the body is the seer. Right? The seer is not the eyes. Eyes are just the instruments. Who sees through the eyes?
Body.
No.
Mind.
Mind also is seen by somebody. We have to go, we are like that, we have to go inside. So the deepest seer we have to see. The innermost seer. That is called Atma. Are we clear? So you will be clear? The body, the layer, this body is like a temple, it's a fort. Somebody inside is sitting, seeing through this body. Who is that inside? Is Atma. We have to go there. But for that, you have to cross each gate. Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, Anandamaya Kosha. Are you clear? So the first step is Dharana. Now it's the seeing, Dhyana. Are you clear? When seeing, just see. Don't make judgment. Just watch. Right? So now you tie the horse. Don't move the horse. So don't worry about the breathing. So breathe, forget about breathing now. Now just take your attention to the forehead Atma chakra here, where you put kumkum now. How do you take? Don't strain your eyes. Gently, gently look there. Eyes will little bit move here. Gently look there. You can feel small pressure there. Small pull there. Can you do that? Now when you do that, the mind stops. Mind reduces the speed. Now horse is tied. Just watch what's going on there. It'll see small sensations, vibrations, and silence, peace. Vaishali, are you doing?
Yes, Guruji.
Practice. So, yes. Now second step is you have tied your horse and you are watching. Watching the first gate. The gate of the body called Adna Chakra. Slowly open your eyes. Is everybody able to do to the second step? Can you explain to me what happened there? What happens there? When you watch? Rajini?
No thoughts.
Rajini, no thoughts, right? So if thoughts come also, ignore. Okay, just ignore.
Feel the sensation.
Just feel the sensation.
Feeling the sensation.
Just feel the sensation. There is a silence also. Mind becomes silent. Can you see that?
Yes.
Okay. thoughts come and ignore the thoughts. Correct? So please, people, actually people tell you meditation is watching the thought. Watching the thought is not required. Watching the Ajna Chakra is required. Because watching the thought, catching the thought is like catching the air. You cannot catch them. It will go somewhere. You will run. Are you able to understand what I am saying? Shruti, what happens? Can you tell me, explain?
A sensation in the middle part, and you feel that the mind is calm.
Mind is calm, right? And thoughts come, now thoughts will reduce. Are you clear?
Yes, correct.
Thoughts will reduce, right? So now you have tied the horse and you are watching. Don't expect anything to happen, just watch. Okay, just watch slowly and some whatever is there you observe. Don't judge, don't comment.
The concentration will be on observing, Guruji.
Yes, yes. I am not saying concentration. I am not saying concentration. Gently observe. Concentration. Oh, like for example, I want to concentrate. That's not concentration.
So it automatically gets concentrated there.
I don't use the word concentration. Just pay attention because concentration has a force. No force.
Okay, okay.
Don't use force. Right?
Okay.
You can concentrate on work, but you don't have to concentrate here. Just be aware. Gently.
Yes. Yes.
Are you? Is Srinivas clear? Srinivas? You got,
It's clear, Guruji.
Yeah, mind becomes silent. Are you able to observe that?
Reduced a bit, but not completely to zero.
Yeah, that's okay. As you practice, okay. Now, if you have too much trouble in tying the horse, what you have to do again? Again, go back to step number one. Got it? Dharana. Dharana. If you are not able to get mind is not becoming silent, go back to step number one.
Sure, yes.
Right? Slow down,
yeah.
Then come down. See, can you tie a running horse? You cannot tie a running horse. Horse has to slow down and then tie.
Yes.
Is it clear to all? Vaishali?
Yes, Guruji.
So your horse is running or slow down?
It's slowing down.
Satyalata, clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so where is the horse now? Horse is there here only or somewhere else?
It's there, but it's calm.
It's calm, okay? Don't allow your horse to go into somebody else's places. Keep it your
horse. Horse is with Guruji. Horse is with Guruji.
I have so many donkeys actually. Okay. So Pratibha Rao, clear up, madam? Pratibha Rao, are you clear? You have to enable the video, audio. Are you clear?
Yes, clear, sir. It was calm.
Yeah, first step you joined, I think you joined a little bit late now. You have to slow down the breathing, first step.
Yes, yes.
And second step is after slowing down the breathing, you have to tie the horse. Mind is the horse.
Yes. Yes.
Breath is the rein. Slow down,
okay.
Then tie down. Okay? So two steps are over. Are you clear? Now we'll go to third step. That's called Samadhi.
Pulsation will be there.
Huh?
The pulsation will be there.
Correct. Pulsation will be there. Are you able to see the mind is slow down? Mind, no thoughts, less thoughts?
Yes.
There's a calmness in the mind and mind has thought, no thought, less thoughts, correct?
Less thoughts.
Correct? So next step is called Samadhi. Okay? What is Samadhi? Now you ask the question, who am I? Okay? So ask the question, who am I? And don't worry about the breath and don't worry about Ajna Chakra. Who am I? Okay? No answer. You don't have to find out answer for who am I. There's no answer for who am I, because there's no answer can come from who am I. What is the answer for who am I? Silence. Okay? Understand? So stay in the silence. Now you don't observe here. Don't worry about the horse. Don't worry about the Adna Chakra. Just stay in silence. That silence is called Samadhi. Are we clear? In that silence, you have become one with God. In silence only we can become one with God. The silence is called awareness. You should be fully aware. You should not be sleeping and silent. Are we clear? Just ask one question, who am I? Don't ask, who am I, 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 who am I? Don't do that. Only one question, who am I? And don't try to find an answer. Who am I? I want to find the answer. Oh, today only I have to find the answer. Don't find the answer. There's no answer for who am I. Only silence is the answer. Okay, as you do that, okay, the silence becomes deeper and deeper and deeper. Okay, the deepest silence is called God. Don't force that. Don't force the silence. Just ask, who am I? Now, after some time, the mind comes up again. Then what you do? Who am I? One time. Just ask, who am I? Once. The mind becomes silent. Stay in that silence. Correct? So then, if the mind becomes too noisy, what you do? Step number 3 to step number 2, then step number 1. Dharana, you go, if mind becomes little bit noisy, ask, who am I? If it becomes too much noisy, step number 2. If number it becomes too noisy, step number 1. Okay, so you have to learn how to ride the horse. Are you clear? This is called Sahaja Samadhi or Natural Samadhi. No force, no pressure, simple, gentle. The more you go into Samadhi, the more your mind becomes purified. Right? Because more you go into Samadhi, more you become one with God. Is that clear? Everybody is clear? So, the step number 1 is Dharana, means slowing down the horse. Step number is called Dhyana, means observation, attention. Dhyana is also called becoming Sakshi. You have to become witness. Witness the body. Witness the Adna Chakra. And third step is Samadhi. Doing nothing. Just be aware. Are you clear? That awareness is called God. That's called Brahman. Just become one with the awareness. Are you clear? We'll do now step number 1, 2, 3 together. Okay, so let's start with step number 1, then let's go to step number 2, I'll guide you, then step number 1, 2, 3, we'll keep doing. So, first step, step number 1, Dharana. Let us start gentle and slow breathing. Slow breathing. Gentle breathing, deep breathing like a child. step number 2, dhyana. Take your attention to Ajna Chakra, forehead. Gently observe the sensation in the forehead. Be the witness, the sakshi. If any thought comes, just ignore and just be the witness. I am able to observe the body, Annamaya Kosha. That's why I am not the body. I am the witness, the sakshi. The body changes, but I am not changing. I am unchanging. I am the witness. Now step number 3, samadhi, sahaja samadhi. Ask the question, who am I? The mind becomes silent. Just stay in that silence. As long as possible, stay in the silence. I'll chant Asato Ma Sadgamaya. Please repeat after me. Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti Shanti, Shanti hi, Purna Madaha, Purna Midam, Purnat, Purna Muduchete, Purnasya, Purna Madaya, Purna Meva Vashishate, Om Shanti. Shanti, Shanti hi, लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु हरिः ओम् श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम् Slowly open your eyes. So, is step number 1, 2, 3 clear to all? If you have problem in step number 3, you have to come back to step number 2. If you have problem in step number 2, you have to come back to step number 1. Like that, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, you have to go up and down. Finally, more and more time you have to stay in 3. Are we clear? So now what will happen here, okay, what happens here by doing this is that more and more your mind merges with the Atma. So when the mind merges with the Atma, mind becomes more and more pure and silent. You understand? It is a very simple, natural process. It's called Sahaja Samadhi. Naturally, you will become more and more pure, more and more God, divine comes into your body and mind. The Atma qualities come in the mind. Rajini, is it clear to you? Sujaya?
Yes, Sujaya, Prabhuji.
It's clear now. Sujaya, it's clear to you? Subbulakshmi? Swapna? Swapna? Satyalata, you disappeared.
Yes, clear, Prabhuji.
Why do you disappear once in a while?
No, I was here all through.
Oh, that means you disappeared. You entered into Samadhi. I could not see you. Okay, now this...
But in the three stages, Prabhuji, in the first stage, Dharana stage, I feel it is... we are doing something like holding on to the breath.
Right.
In the second stage, we are just observing.
Sakshi.
In the third stage, just be.
Just be. You merge with the awareness. Awareness is God, okay? So now what you are doing is, this is actually going from outside to inside. And the more you go outside to inside, what will happen to you is, I'll tell you. You have a ink. Let us take a glass. Just take a glass. Just here, the plain glass. Okay, now let us say I have a glass here and I put some water. Then I put one ink drop. Okay, one ink drop. So the water, what is the color of the water?
Blue.
The water will become blue. Correct? So the water is your mind, the glass is your body. Okay? So now, the water has become blue. So I want to make you water again. I want to remove the, make you, I want, you want to remove the color again. How do you remove the color? I want you to
take out the water.
No. Water should be there. Water should not, you cannot take out. You have to remove the color. What do you do? Lata?
Add more water. More water.
So, only way to remove the color is add more water. Correct? That adding more water is God, Brahman, silence. So once, as you go, your mind goes back again and again to Brahman, awareness, the ink drop will go. Ink is pollution in the mind. Okay? You understand? Mind is polluted. How does mind get polluted? So how does the ink drop gets into mind? How does the ink get mind get polluted? Pratibha?
By the ego. Thoughts.
But when you interact with the world, I want this, there's fighting, there's a struggle, there's a strain, the mind gets polluted, ink drops gets added. Got it?
More and more thoughts also.
More and more thoughts will come. That's the pollution. Correct?
And even desires.
And desires. Then how
and
do you... So now this has, ink has become, my mind has become polluted. How do you clean the mind?
Clean
by doing these three steps. And when you go more and more, the silence will come to mind, more and more the water will get added. Then the mind will become more and more pure. Are you clear? But then after meditation, you again come back, again same fighting, again same trouble, again the ink will come. You understand? Because you have to interact with the society. Correct? Then what you do? Again go back, again do that. How do you, how many times you have to do? How often you have to do? As much as possible. It is like almost like washing your teeth. So every day you wash your teeth. If you don't wash your teeth, what will happen to you? Smell will come. If you don't wash for 2 days, the smell will come to the next person. If you don't wash 3 days, the smell will be there in the whole room. That's like your mind also. The mind is already smelling, rotting. I can through the mobile internet I can see the smell. Yeah, this is the process of cleaning the mind. Going back to the Atma, coming back. Going back to the Atma and coming back. Every day, as often you have to do. The more often you do, the more pure it will become. Correct? So you should not ask me how much you have to do. You have to do as much as possible, whenever possible. But you should not sleep. You should be fully aware. No sleeping. Okay? In sleep also you go to Atma, but unconsciously, that won't help you. Are you clear? No. Consciously you have to go back to Atma. The consciously union has to happen. Are you clear? Everybody? Any questions? So next assignment for you. There are 6 lessons in Atma Darshan program. Gayatri will post that 6 lessons. Go through that 6 lessons. Okay? Each lesson is about 45 minutes to 1 hour. You go through that. 6 lessons. So next week, there's a test for you. You ask me the question. If I fail the test, I will not come to the classes. Or I will ask the question. And if you fail, you don't come to the classes.
You can't miss.
So, listen to the class, understand, then ask the questions next class. Then I will take you next Dharana Dhyana Samadhi, little bit deeper level. Like that, each stage I will take you little bit deeper. Dharana Dhyana Samadhi, deeper and deeper I will take you. Are you clear? Is it simple? You can practice? Okay. So now I'll chant. What is it?
One question.
Yes, who has that question?
Miguel.
One minute.
Guruji,
one minute.
By doing the daily core activities.
Huh? Sorry?
By doing the daily activities, how can we practice this one?
This 8 classes you attend, you'll know how to practice everything. Right? You are actually right now just trying to understand how the horse is and how to figure out the horses. You are asking the more questions. What will I do with the horse? So that I will teach you in each class little bit. I can't give you too much now.
No, Guruji, lot of disturbance is coming up.
Where? In the mind or in the internet? In the internet. In the internet I am okay. In the mind then we have a problem.
Coming to you, it will not be there, Guru.
Okay. So, I will tell you each step I will study. I will take you step by step. I don't want to make over.